Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now, as I said in the last part, it's about time to move on to level 4. There's actually a couple different ways to get to level 4. You could either go through these gates. I think this will cost you 3 or 4 keys, or maybe even more. You might be able to see below me, the portal is actually surrounded by those yellow and blue bricks that you can see there. So there's no way to use your mattock or anything else to get in there. You really have to open all these doors. But I am not going to do that, as you might have expected from the way I just said that. There is a different way into level 4, and this different way is beneficial in a couple of different ways. So I'm just going to show you how to get there. First thing we have to do is go all the way back to level 1. So that's where I'm going right now. I'm not going to show you the very boring long walk back, so I'll stop recording for a moment and I'll see you when I get back to level 1. And we're back. Okay, as you can see, I just came out of the portal to level 2. I'm now back in the very first level. Did I take out the fire elemental on this side? Let me check real quick. Nope. Since we now have our upgraded gear, we can easily take out these fire elementals that were very strong when we were first all the way back here. Might not seem worthwhile for 30 experience and a few gold and a lamp, but if I let it respawn a couple of times, we'll get the strong fire elemental version, which, as you can see, give us 100 gold, 100 experience each. But more importantly, they give us a pendant. And pendants are valuable. I think that's the last respawn for this one, yeah. So yeah, just a little side mission there. So yeah, now how to get to the level 4 from level 1, taking kind of a shortcut. Now, from the area where you first entered the first level, just go all the way up, go past this other little secret passage that we made earlier, and look for the one over here. Now you can see this door is hidden by, or protected by, three doors, so just like our earlier secret passage thingy, I'm going to make life a little bit easier by using a mattock, which will save us the gold from the keys, as well as prevent us from having to do this little jumping trick to get in there. Yeah, I'll just dig in straight from above. It's okay, we can get out of there still. The reason I'm not digging in from the side is because it's easy, if you walk in here from the side, to accidentally hit the door and lose a key that way. If you drop in, that's not going to happen. You can always just jump back out by keeping up pressed and just jumping out like this. So yeah, this door, any portal always just leads to the next level, so it's a little bit hidden. You actually get into this little hidden area of level 2, and from there into the hidden area in level 3. Which again is completely protected by these yellow and blue bricks, so normally you would not be able to get in here in any way, whether you use mattocks, whether you use anything. It's a pretty big shopping area as well, so later on in the game it's pretty convenient to have all the shopping stuff. If you want to take a shortcut back to level 1, go to the king and do some shopping on the way back. It's a pretty nice area to have open anyway. And these monsters here will give us a little bit of extra experience, even some extra gold as well. I lost most of my gold again just now. I had to buy a bunch of food because we're really starting to burn through it very quickly now. So it doesn't hurt to pick up some extra gold here. And yeah, it's just a nice shortcut. Again, especially if you want to later on go back to the king or anything like that. Yeah, why not just kill him? Now we're about to move up to level 4, which is going to be a little bit more challenging than what we faced up to so far. The reason for this is that, as you know, we've really been using overpowered armor and weapons for the previous few levels, because we've been able to save enough gold to basically buy stuff that's kind of more than we really needed for the levels we were in. From here on, however, we're going to have a slightly harder time, because while the monsters will still increase in power, our weapons are already, or at least our armor is already more or less maxed. We can buy one level higher, which eventually I'll do. But for the moment, we're going to be stuck with half plate, and the monsters in level 3 have no trouble with killing you through the half plate armor. It'll get better with our shields. We'll be able to find bigger and bigger shields in the next few levels, but frankly, we're going to be taking a bunch of damage pretty quickly now. Just get these guys out of the way. Again, pick up some more gold. Oh, jeez, I forgot these guys drop poison. That's kind of annoying. But we were already kind of low on health, so I guess it's not that huge a deal. Unless I'm gonna let these lizard men kill me, in which case, I suck. Thankfully, that's not gonna happen. Yeah, let's just move on to level 4. We'll have to use one key to get through here, but other than that, we'll be home free. So our first look at level 4. Immediately you'll notice that level 4 is a little bit more strange than the previous levels. The other ones all had fairly simple corridors and ladders and things. Level 4 has a lot of these weird going up, going down, going back, going forward. There's also a bunch of different places where you'll teleport to annoying areas and that sort of thing. So yeah, level 4 has a little bit more tricks up its sleeve. It also has a bunch of these, which look like towers, but you can actually go in. So that's useful. Oh, cockatrice, let me think. They are pretty strong, but mostly thanks to their magic. And if I'm not mistaken, the second version of them can give you a lot of gold, so let's check that out right away. Where are you? Maybe he's down here somewhere. Okay, can't go up there. Oh, I guess we'll find him later. Oh, there he is. Oh yeah, that's right. It does give you a lot of gold, but it always spawns only one guy, so kind of a waste. There we go. See, 200 each, which is nice, but there's only one, so yeah, kind of pointless. These guys are powerful magic users, if I'm not mistaken, so we'll leave those for now. Might actually not be such a bad idea to run back to the king and get our magic resistance up, because from this level onward, magic is going to be a much bigger problem. You know what? I'll do that right now. After I kill these guys. Oh yeah, Shriekers, they use deck attacks, so they can very quickly do a lot of damage to you, and they don't even have to aim or anything. But since they always drop food, you can just take them out with your own deck spell and not worry about them too much. Hornets are these guys, and you don't want to fight those yet, because they're very strong indeed. I think, yeah, in this sort of blue-yellow area is a door to, I think, the next level. I think you have to fall down this middle one, but we're really not ready to go there yet. Oh yeah, I might as well show you this guy. This is the portal back to level 3, which you'd normally come through if you went through the regular exit. As you can see, you need a lot of keys to get in here. So using our little shortcut saved us a bunch of keys, as well as giving us a nice quick access to level 1. Just trying to think if there's anything specific I need to show you in this level, but I think it's all... There's nothing too crazy in here. Don't fall down any holes where you don't see any exit, because they may very well get you stuck or lock you into places. Oh yeah, this is the one. Yep, I think this is the first castle we're going to be clearing out. So yeah, this gives you a pretty good idea of what level 4 is like. I'm desperately avoiding most of these guys because they are strong. So yeah, what I'll do is I'll go off screen, I'll go back to the king, upgrade my magic resistance a bunch, because I think we're really gonna need it for this level. I'm pretty sure I can get either two or three levels from the king right now. Pretty sure we can at least get one or two magic levels and probably a fire level as well. But in any case, I'll see if I can do that off screen, and I'll see you in the next part, guys. Thanks for watching.